In this video I'm going to show you how to set up the deadliest trap for the Australian turtle player when it comes to the three-player situation. With the help of your ally you completely prevent the Australian player from invading your and your ally's big continents. Both of you start crushing the troops you get into that unlucky Australian player, and then by either outsmarting your ally or by your ally making a mistake, you can very likely win the game. But this strategy will obviously be demonstrated at the end. It is the beginning of the game and we need to get rid of three of the players. This is classic Risk map game with alliances on, 60 seconds per turn, and balanced blitz dice rolls. Well, gotta admit that it was really unlucky for the blue player to lose all the troops in 7 versus 3 blitz roll, but oh well. Bad blitz rolls sometimes happen. This game is being played with my subscribers, so we will be able to make the best of our moves, without being afraid to get sussed on, like it usually happens with random public lobby players. In case you want to know, the green player is beginner, the blue and orange players are masters, and the yellow and purple players are grandmasters. It seems to be a tough combination of players, so wish me best of luck guys, let's hope for the best. It seems I will be without a continent for a while or won't even get it all. I would have gone for Australia but the yellow player added his troops here, so I decided not to fight with them for it. With the green player capturing Europe, or the continent which gives even 5 troops, someone will have to keep invading it, and the most sense to attack him will make 4 small continent players, so the sooner small continent players get continents, the sooner they will be able to attack him. So this is why I'm being helpful to yellow by moving my troops out from Australia, even though we are not allies. The purple player has just invaded green to prevent him from becoming much more stronger than anybody else, and that is really good. And since the orange player got a continent, he should be looking forward to help out purple to attack the green player as well, if he had a good access to do so of course, and not necessarily straightly, but after becoming stronger than no continent players, he definitely should. If the main goal is to play the game in the most efficient way possible, to not prolong the game, and at the same time to not let someone become way stronger or taking advantage over others. The Australian, South American, and African players should be looking forward to team up with each other, especially Australian and South American players, since African player could be more vulnerable with having even 3 borders, but after a few turns of holding Africa, he should help out to South American and Australian players too, so he wouldn't be taking advantage and hoarding troops while the Australian and South American players would be doing all the dirty work. And what I mean by teaming up with each other, is that they should unite to get rid of the 3 other players who didn't get small continents, so they would guarantee the advantage for themselves, and at the same time the game wouldn't prolong. And the most sense for them makes to start attacking the player or players who go for big continents, cause obviously all 3 of you have to stay the strongest in the game, as otherwise if you let someone hold North America or Europe, then that player by being the strongest, could eventually eliminate any player he wants, and that destroyed player could be as well as a no continent player, as well as a small continent player, so as small continent players you wouldn't like to put yourselves in a potential risk as well. But if someone from no continent player starts getting quite strong, then you should definitely keep an eye on him and attack him if needed too. And obviously all 3 of you, the small continent players, should team up with each other and try to attack equally, as if someone of you won't be attacking at all or not as much, then that person will be taking over advantage when 2 others do the dirty work. And then 2 others by seeing that, could stop attacking as well, and then the game could really become a stalemate, so it's really bizarre when the strongest player or players do not attack anyone at all when it comes to the 6-player situation playing with decent, not suicidal players. As it really makes the game to be unnecessarily prolonged. After seeing that I'm not getting Australia, my another potential plan was to go for North America depending on the player's generosity, cause sometimes they will just let hold big continents anyways, trying to turtle rather than teaming up, but not this time, obviously I'm not getting North America, especially with the orange player building a big army in Venezuela rather than putting some troops outside the Americas, and sure thing with the yellow player adding his troops there. So for now I'm just putting all my troops to one big army and waiting to see what happens. As a no-continent player, I'm not attacking green, as by doing that I would just help out the small continent players to get rid of us much easier. And another thing is that the green player doesn't properly guard Europe anyways, he leaves ones on his borders, so that's no-brainer for the small continent players to invade him at all. Well, when it comes to the purple player, he could be afraid of possible retaliation of getting invaded as well, but the Australian and South American players can definitely keep invading him, and potentially even crushing some troops into him. Well, at least when it comes to orange. The purple and yellow player did and are doing their part, while the orange player just attacks one territory per turn while having quite more troops than them. So in this case we could potentially say that the orange player is prolonging the game or at least taking the advantage of this situation, so he could even discourage purple and yellow from attacking no continent players as well, the game becoming one long boring stalemate. So for that not to happen, he could definitely consider helping purple and yellow out by attacking the green player as well. Or I mean not necessarily green, he can crush some troops into either me or blue. But I would say it would be better to get rid of the sixth player as soon as possible, so after getting rid of him, it would be easier for the small continent players to team up since instead of three unnecessary opponents, there would only be two left. And when small continent players attacking one no continent player rather than all of them at once, there are way less chances that they decide to team up with each other by seeing that only one of them is getting targeted. So by seeing that the orange player could potentially crush his 12 troops army into me, I decided to move out from North America. I mean I wasn't getting it anyways, and basically there's not much difference for me where to keep putting my troops to one big army. But another thing what I noticed is that the orange player is only looking for benefit only for himself, but not to team up mutually with others in order for the game not to be such a stalemate. So I think he could potentially decide to expand to North America, and if so, then I highly believe that he would bring a lot of attention to himself, and might even get targeted by the small continent players, since he wouldn't be one of them anymore. So that actually would be good for me and other no continent players. When it comes to the yellow player, I like his efforts to attack the most of all small continent players, but I think he's doing that not really efficiently. He captures a lot of territories, but what actually happens with them, they all get recaptured by other players one by one. Especially I would say there's no need to capture territories in North America since the orange player captures territories here. So basically the yellow player keeps capturing the territories of four different people. And that's not a really an efficient way to finally get rid of someone. And in a six-player situation you could barely increase your territorial troop bonus anyways. So instead of capturing tons of territories, I would rather say that the yellow player could have crushed some of the troops to the green player. Green, it's because he is already the weakest, so by highly weakened he could even get potentially eliminated even by other no continent player. Like the blue player for example who targets the green player as well. But I mean by the yellow player crushing some troops into green instead of capturing a lot of territories, the purple and orange players could get encouraged to do the same as well, especially if the yellow player would send them the attack requests to do so. The blue player sends me attack requests to attack orange, but honestly he shouldn't be the one to show the initiative to attack someone by being the second weakest player, who doesn't get targeted by others, so he isn't in a danger when it comes to survival question. The strongest players are the ones who should always attack others and show the initiative to do so for the other strong players too. So the orange player should have been the one who was expected to do some attacks, but he is expecting for others to do all the dirty work for him in a smart player's game. Like we wouldn't be so stupid to destroy each other so much, that he would even have more troops than all of us combined, or like get a tremendous advantage. So in the situations when the strongest player is a complete turtling player, then the other strongest player should team up on him in order for the game not to be a stalemate but at the same time for the weakest players not to get into a huge disadvantage comparing to others. So I'm really glad that after the blue player showing the initiative, the second and third strongest players, purple and yellow, started to attack the orange player as well, even though it should have been the other way around, since the blue player is the second weakest. But yeah, I see that I'm getting closer to becoming one of the strongest players too, so I will consider attacking the orange player too. So I'm really glad that after the blue player showing the initiative, the second and third strongest players, purple and yellow, started to attack the orange player as well, even though it should have been the other way around, since the blue player was the second weakest. But yeah, I see that I'm getting closer to becoming one of the strongest players too, so I will consider attacking the orange player too. I mean, I've got to the yellow player troops level and quite close to the purple player's troops level too, but let's not forget that they have continents while I'm not, so if I waste a lot of troops, then it won't be as easier for me to regain the troops comparing to them. But yeah, now I think I should really attack orange since the yellow player's army became quite smaller. And the player who should target the orange player the most is obviously purple. So I'm really glad that the purple player has finally invaded orange into poorly guarded South America. And to be honest, I was surprised that the green player got to finally hold unguarded Europe. It's usually bad to let others hold big continents, like especially if you see that they just want to turtle and don't even guard their borders, but I mean for that I can blame myself too, since the small continent players are not a potential threat for me anymore since everyone is teaming up on orange, so differently than in the beginning of the game. Now I could invade the green player into Europe too, since we are not unfortunate destiny buddies anymore. What I mean is that small continent players should have supposed to team up on us, no continent players, in order for them to keep and sustain the advantage for themselves. But since the orange player didn't help them out at all wanting to keep being the strongest, all of the players' attention went to him. Well, the orange player neither the threat nor the strongest player anymore, so we could stop teaming up on him. But since we already so intensively started, I think it's the best to continue doing so until he gets eliminated. I mean, we need to finally get rid of one of the players for the game not to be such a stalemate. And what would be the point to keep the orange player being alive anyways, if he would get back to turtling without attacking anyone once again? Doesn't make much sense if our goal is to prevent the stalemate from happening. So taking all of that into account and at the same time becoming one of the strongest players, I decided to jump on the bandwagon and attack the orange player as well. Before I did so, he sent me a heart emoji, but it didn't help him to change my decision at all, because he wasn't a good ally. Actually, he was more of an enemy rather than ally since he wanted to prevent me from capturing North America, so I obviously considered our alliance to be faked. All of the players sent me the alliance requests and I gladly accepted them all. I mean, why wouldn't have I when having no continent at all, which put me into the risk of getting eliminated one of the first players back then. And I mean, you can always later on decide which players you want to stay allied with, and with which of them not, who of them are mutually beneficial and who are not so much, or who just sent you an alliance request just for the sake of sending the alliance request, insignificantly without much meaning. Or like that you just wouldn't attack them into their continents, that they would just be turtling without attacking anyone. Probably of them having made the alliances with all of the players or at least the most of them. So even though I'm allied with everyone, I'm only enjoying to be allied with the yellow and blue players since they are the ones who tries to make the game to be stalemated the least. So after the orange player will be eliminated, I would like to stay being allies with them to team up on the remaining players. When invading orange, I didn't hesitate to go through green's and purple's continents, because they're kinda playing like the orange player as well, hoping that the game solves itself with them turtling in their continents and not doing much. Well, the green player as well as me doesn't have to do much, so it's the best for him to keep turtling in Europe and get these 5 troop bonuses when others let him hold Europe from time to time. The green player was the weakest player, but he actually recovered well and became as decent opponent as others. And the purple player has been the strongest for a while now, so actually he should be the one to eliminate the orange player, but not blue, who is the weakest. But of course, when the blue player is being so self-destructive, it's good for him when the dirty work is being done by itself. But he still is the strongest player, should attack someone to not stalemate the game. So if he wants to let the blue player to keep dealing with the orange player alone, then he could still attack some other player, probably the best player for him to attack being the green player, since the yellow player is already attacking him, and plus the green player never retaliates after being attacked, so very likely the purple player would still be able to successfully hold Africa, while if he attack me, then I could potentially consider invading him into Africa and leaving my whole army there. He has never attacked me yet, so it's unknown for him what I would do. But yeah, after the green player I would be the next best option for the purple player to attack. While the blue player targeting orange, and with the yellow player being another small continent player, probably helping him to target his selected player. And yeah, as much as I loved the blue player's initiative at first when other players started him helping to attack the orange player as well, now I think he is really overdoing that. At this point he is very likely ruining the game for himself at the same time as well, but not only for orange. And probably I don't think that the fifth place is that he really wants. So in this case I would let stronger players to keep finish dealing with the orange player, particularly the purple player since he is the strongest. And yeah guys, the blue player has just ruined the game for both of them, currently they're both the weakest basically dead players. The orange player gets so lucky to get a set at 3 cards though. But that still doesn't unfortunately change the fact for him that he stays the weakest. So since the purple player is quite stronger than others, he should really take the orange player out in order for the game not to be a stalemate, and that he wouldn't take over advantage, in case someone other did the dirty work for him. So let's see what the purple player actually does. It seems he won't crush some troops into anyone. He just attacked one territory just to get a card, so he could grow strong while others would be doing the dirty work for him by attacking someone in order that the game wouldn't stalemate. I mean when you're the strongest player and you specially block your biggest army on purpose when there are so many players left, then that just really indicates that you just want to turtle and not even really looking forward to attack someone later on. Don't get me wrong though. It can be a very smart tactic playing with the public lobby players, especially low ranked. But when you play with decent people in a subscriber game, then it just isn't going to work when everyone knows the secret of turtling, the game is just going to become one dragged out stalemate. And the worst thing when the strongest player doesn't attack anyone, is that others cannot really much attack either. As while wasting troops they're gonna let the strongest player to become quite stronger than anybody else. Then that strongest player will have a choice which player he wants to eliminate, and that unlucky player could potentially be any of you, including the second strongest player if he is quite weaker. And that's really bad, because you can never know whether you will be that unlucky player. And if that strongest player really becomes quite stronger than the second strongest player, then the try of teaming up can go really wrong for the player who shows the initiative first. As obviously the strongest player will most likely want to take that player out much more than anybody else. So if that happens, then other players are just forced to turtle as well as him, so later on instead of taking out the attacking player specifically, which can be you if you decide to attack him, he would take any of the players out randomly. Anyways, the reason why I decided to move out to North America, is because first of all I saw that it was cleared out, and second of all by potentially holding it, I want to become the strongest player, so by becoming the strongest player I could start crushing my troops into someone, so the game wouldn't be a stalemate and we could finally get rid of some of the players. But of course the purple player invades me. But that was expected, I thought that either yellow or purple will invade me, so this is why I didn't guard one of the borders, so the purple player's surplus troops wouldn't be used on me. Well, at least he has blocked his biggest army once again, so that gives me some hopes. Also I guarded from Asia rather than Europe, because it wouldn't be beneficial for me to be enemies with green, so he would let me hold the same size continent as well, I'm showing the trust and it would be mutually beneficial for us. And if somebody wanted to invade me, then firstly that person would need to go through green assuming if the easiest way is taken with the least troops required to crush. So in that case there would be no player who holds 5 troops continent. Well, I thought the green player would be my best ally in this situation, well not like that much of a good ally, but just not invading me since all the game he was basically as passive as me, but oh well, we neither had the opportunities to become the strongest players, nor even could hold any continents successfully. Well, Green could, but not that much. It just let him from the weakest become as strong as average players again. But yeah, the person who unexpectedly became my best ally is Yellow. I think he placed 10 troops army on Iceland because it could protect my border. Especially from Purple, since I believe that they're both allied. And that's really appreciated. I assume the Yellow player understands what I want to do, so he helps me to get North America, so we could team up and finally get rid of someone, once the Purple player won't be so much intimidating. Or to be honest, we could even team up on Purple, since there always be a stalemate problem with the Turtling player, who was the strongest player doesn't attack anyone, but differently, even blocks his biggest army. Well, not anymore it seems. The Purple player is the strongest player has finally showed some action going on by taking the Blue player out. And that's great. And with trading in a set after taking the Blue player out, in overall he only lost 10 troops. Before taking out Blue he had 101 troops, and after taking him out 91 of them. But also taking into the account that before he had one card, and now he has four, he basically didn't lose anything, but at the same time he got rid of the sixth player who was not really needed in the game in order for the balance of the game to be sustained. So in overall it turned out to be as well as good for Purple, as well as good for the whole game. Anyways, I'm not sure whether now still is the strongest player he would finally take the orange player out or start crushing some troops into other players or not, like if he considered taking someone out only if he saw that he would regain all the troops like with the Blue player or not. So by not knowing that, I have taken a bunch of territories of him, showing to the Yellow player I would be willing to attack someone, but not just getting a lot of troops and doing nothing, becoming the next big turtle. Well, maybe it wasn't the best call for me to capture a lot of Purple territories after he had just taken the Blue player out, without seeing whether he would target someone next or not. So since I captured some territories of Purple, now he decided to crush some troops into me, rather than to one of the weaker players. But looking from my perspective, he invaded me into North America back then and even officially broke the alliance with me. And with him additionally being a very big turtling player, my decision to capture some territories of him was based on all of that. But like I said, it would been smarter to just wait for one turn to see what he actually does, whether he would have attacked me or not, whether he would have wanted to team up on the weaker players or not. So that wasn't the best diplomacy move made by me, even though I just mostly wanted to show for Yellow that I would be an aggressive player. Anyways, all of that currently doesn't matter anymore, as the Green player has just decided to destroy himself on the Purple player. I guess he probably got bored since the game lasted so long without the situation changing much, or maybe he had to go and couldn't play anymore. And I mean that's fine. He wasted his troops on the strongest player, without ruining him the game that much, and at the same time not breaking the balance of the game. So no player could easily win by not having as many troops as other players combined. And finally we got no bots in the game, which always tend to make the game more boring, well at least when it comes to me, as I know that for some of you it might be completely differently. Anyways, the worst thing for me that the Yellow player after that decided to betray me, with the Purple player already not really liking me at all, and with the Orange player being negatively against me as well, with him fortifying his biggest army next to me. And with me being without a continent at all, that probably puts me to be that fourth player which the rest of the players will be looking forward to eliminate. Especially if the Yellow player by being the strongest crushes a lot of troops into me. I was really hoping to continue teaming up with the Yellow player at least to the three player situation. But probably with the Yellow player not really liking that I'm the one with the biggest continent, he decided to betray me. And I mean it was his choice. Everyone makes the moves which they think are the best for the game or themselves. But he would be better taking the orange player out over here. Well, he didn't. So better he would be either crushing these troops into me, or fortifying them to his Australian army. That should be a really game deciding move for him. And phew, with him at the end not fortifying his troops to his Australian army, that made me so happy, and that was a big relief for sure. as what he was thinking, that with me being without a continent at all, I just simply do nothing and wait till other players destroy me little by little. The answer was obviously no. With him being the strongest player and at the same time targeting me rather than someone else, he left me no choice but to take Australia from him, as to attack either orange or purple while getting attacked by the strongest player would have been obviously stupid for me, as it would have given even more advantage to him, and to accept the slow death by others crushing their troops into me wouldn't have been a great decision either. I really appreciated the yellow player as a very good ally since he helped me out with North America, and wanted to keep him in the top 3, but with him betraying me, he had really left me no other choice with him targeting me. And also to overexpand by capturing North America and Europe while having Australia too, was probably a bad decision as well. He brought the player's attention to him by trying to hold too much stuff, so now he gets targeted by other players as well. So for him the plan to highly increase the territorial bonus, unfortunately didn't really work out that well. I mean it was a really game deciding choice for him of what to do with his second outside Australian army after he had betrayed me. To be in the top 3 probably the safest choice would have been to take the orange player out with that army he had back then. Another great choice would have been to crush that army into me since I was the strongest player after him. Or finally he could have fortified that army to the Australian army, so I wouldn't have crushed his Australian army at the same time taking Australia from him. And to crush his troops into purple would have probably been not so good decision, the purple player was the third strongest player, and by crushing his troops into him, the yellow player would have potentially risked to break the balance of the game to my favor. So if I were yellow, then I wouldn't have considered crushing that army into purple as a possible option, but to either take the orange player out, or to crush that army into red, would have been a very tempting decision for sure. But since he has chosen wrong, I think now it's the time to say a goodbye to him. I mean I don't want to stalemate the game, I want to get rid of the fourth player, who is not really needed in order for the balance of the game to be sustained, as soon as possible. The purple player has just sent me an alliance request, and that probably means that he is taking the yellow player out. And that's right, the yellow player has been eliminated. So I'm wondering what the purple player does now. And oh no guys, the purple player is a very sneaky player. He has just allied with me just in the same turn to become my enemy once again. I mean it's clear for me that he wants to use the strategy in which the African slash European player allies with the both America's player, so they could equally crush their troops into the Australian player while letting each other hold big continents. And unfortunately to me the orange player decides to follow the idea rather than invading purple. So it could be it guys, I might get the third place, but I'm not giving up easily. I couldn't break through one of the purple player borders because it would break the balance of the game, and just to fortify my army next to his borders, wouldn't have been much impactful either. So since the orange player didn't capture the Kamchatka territory, I decided to completely block him by fortifying my army there by myself. So the orange player by seeing that he cannot attack any territories of mine, would invade purple. And my strat seemed to work out, well at least for a little bit, the orange player just invaded Africa instead of the both purple's continents. And another thing, is that even though the orange player sent me thumbs up, he still didn't move out his biggest army away from me, nor fortified at least some troops away from it to guard against purple. So I'm gonna call this fake thumbs up, it just clearly indicates that he would like to continue teaming up with purple on me. He invaded purple into Africa just because purple captured Australia, so they both would be still getting the same number of troops. The orange player could easily invade purple into Europe but he won't, and at the same time won't even guard North America from purple. So I think it's pretty clear that the orange player by trying to appear possibly friendly, would just like that I would just move out my army from Kamchatka. But there's no way I'm leaving from here, it will only go one way, through North America, so unless I would see that I could easily break through either Ukraine or Middle East. But the purple player still won't move out his armies from here, even with the orange player breaking through his continents. So I'm just forced to wait in Kamchatka until there is a real conflict starts going on between them. So far it looks like kid games, they're kinda get mad on each other, will break through their continents, just to end up not guarding them once again, leaving their biggest armies focused on me. So if I move out my army from Kamchatka, there would be a high possibility that they would decide to team up with each other once again. And for those who don't really understand how the Purple and Orange Players Alliance was supposed to work, let me explain for a little bit. With me being trapped in Australia, and with them getting the same number of troops by holding big continents, they were supposed to equally crush them into me, so they would eliminate me, but of course keeping an eye on the troop counter, so nobody would sacrifice himself just to end up getting the second place. But by blocking Orange I prevented them from teaming up on me, well at least it possibly looked like for them, I mean the purple player could have just started crushing troops into me like he was supposed to, and the orange player could have just used the manual rolls to weaken me. But still, the problem for the orange player would have been, is that the purple player's turn is after mine, so what I mean is that the purple player would have been able to betray the orange player firstly, and with me blocking orange player, the orange player wouldn't have been able to retaliate in that same exact turn, so in that case the purple player would have gotten two turns advantage over orange, and might even ended up of having more troops than both of the opponents combined. So by using that strategy, the orange player would have had quite bigger chances to get outsmarted by. Anyways, now I'm so happy that I was able to get out of the situation which was supposed to be losing for me. The orange player decided to change his front and moved out from my army, he told me to attack purple and I sent thumbs up to that, I was the man of my word and invaded purple into all his continents. I fortified my army to South America though, the continent which before belonged to Orange, so not sure how frustrating it could have been for Orange if at all. But it seems so far we keep attacking purple, so he might be fine with that. The most important thing personally for me is that I'm not longer in Australia, so the players couldn't trap me anymore so easily like that. By making the yellow player to be eliminated I knew that there could be a chance that they decide to use the Australia blocking strategy when letting each other hold continents. And I knew that these players were aware of this strategy, but I was thinking that most likely they won't pull it off. I mean you can never really know how the three players endgame is going to work. The players could team up in the already showcased way against the Australian player. But not necessarily, the Australian player could team up with the South American player to prevent the third player from holding any continents. So after the purple player captured Africa and Europe properly guarding against me, but not him, it was really a decision point for the orange player whether to capture both of the Americas to team up with purple, or invade purple into his continents, so he could team up with me. And as you saw the orange player went with the first choice, which probably is the most tempting strategy as it lets you get so many troops while being able to team up mutually. But also the three players endgame could go without players really teaming up, but attacking each other without really picking sides, just focusing on whichever player who is the strongest at that moment, but the thing with that way is that if some player makes quite less attacks, then it can encourage other players to make fewer attacks as well. So at first the total number of all player troops decreases, but then grows up again. So if possible, I'm trying to look at the ways which could help me to team up with someone and that would benefit us more or less equally. So like in this case the orange player with his Ukrainian army was pointing to the territory of Middle East, so that led me understand that he wants to team up with me against purple by him capturing and holding Europe, and with me South America and Africa. That's another strategy to team up against the Australian player, it doesn't give as many troops to both of you like with the both of the Americas and Africa plus Europe strategy, but it still can be a very effective strategy to deal with the Australian player in case he doesn't figure out how to make the player stop teaming up on him. Well, in this case the purple player doesn't have to struggle because the orange player instead of fortifying some troops from the Ukrainian army to Alaska, just decided to be the European turtle by fortifying the whole army into the middle of Europe, so that obviously led me to fortifying my Middle East troops to North Africa, so at least I would be able to still hold South America after all. But the thing is that the purple player only invaded me into Africa, while letting orange hold Europe. He wants that I will invade Orange by myself, so I wouldn't be such good buddies with Orange anymore. Well, technically Orange just became neutral, but that still doesn't change the thought that the purple player would like to make me his enemy for Orange. So in order for the orange player not to become as quite stronger player, I could attack him, but not necessarily. I think I came up with even greater plan on how to overcome it, so I could still be in alliance with orange without giving him advantage. By capturing and holding North America, Africa wouldn't mean anything to me anymore. So if the purple player wants to invade me, then he will have to go through orange, or if the purple player just lets me hold North America, then it will be even better for me, so I just hope he doesn't have a set to invade me through Asia. At first I wanted to strengthen that Asian border, but then I changed my mind to fortifying some troops to South America, so the purple player couldn't take it from me, forcing me to go to Australia. If the purple player takes my South American army, then the balance of the game could be very likely broken. So let's see, guys. Alright, he just invaded me and then fortified his army to Africa back. At this point of the game we shouldn't consider attacking each other anymore as the orange player is getting very strong comparing to us. Any attack towards each other could help out the orange player to win the game. And it seems the orange player realized that as well, as now he is just capturing both of our territories. And that's actually good, because he will just make himself to be my and purple's common enemy. His aggression might unite me with purple, especially with the orange player already being the strongest player, so that would make sense to target him either way. So I'm just not sure what about the purple player, what are his current thoughts are. But I already made the first step towards better relationships by moving out my army from Africa, so he could capture it. And as you saw he did, so he is just still being very worried about me because of him keeping the most of troops to my border. I sent him an attack request to attack Orange to let him know that I would like to team up with him, and then told him to attack my territory if needed, so additionally I could capture North America while in Europe. But then I realized that there are no my territories in Europe, there are only orange ones. So I felt stupid for a bit. But I think he should still realize that I want to do, since I put my army to Alaska to protect against orange, while leaving the North American border against the purple player unguarded, and not even putting some more troops to my Brazilian army. But alright, the purple player invaded me into North America instead of capturing Europe. Well, I stupidly told him to attack my territory if he needs to and I didn't even mean it, so after all maybe he got very confused and didn't really understand what I have in mind. Or another option is that he doesn't want to team up with me at all. He strengthened his North African army to threaten me even more. And additionally was mostly looking to team up with Orange on me, or sometimes attacking both of us, but I think he had never showed the initiative to team up with me on Orange. Or maybe after all he just doesn't want to use this strategy with me just because he appears to look weaker than me. And if so, then that's totally understandable. But I mean I would try to equalize our troop numbers by firstly crushing some more troops into orange, and only then expecting to do something from purple. I'm just recapturing North America for one more time and if it gets invaded again, then I'm not really sure what I'm going to do. Then it will be up to orange how the game goes. He is the strongest player and it would only make sense to attack him. But if we don't attack him, with the orange player not attacking someone much either, then the game could really stalemate. But alright, alright. It seems the things have changed for a bit. The purple player is willing to team up with me it seems. The orange player should really invade us here, as if he stayed as passive Australian turtle, then obviously he would get eventually destroyed. So he came up with the right decision to invade us here. But even though the plan to team up with the purple player against orange player went wrong, I'm still glad anyways, as it made the orange player to lose a lot of troops, so with us having fewer troops, the game is supposed to conclude sooner. Our decision to team up has actually made the orange player lose his surplus troops which he possibly wanted to hoard. But wow! It was really unexpected for him to fortify his troops back. I thought it was obvious what destiny is awaiting for him if he stays trapped in Australia, especially when he was trying to pull off the same exact strategy with purple against me back then after we got rid of yellow. So yeah, now the orange player has to come up with something once again to avoid being trapped. But with him not having a big army anymore, now it can be way harder for him to find a good decision. So not sure how it goes for him. And alright, he fortified his biggest army next to purple. The purple player could potentially get scared of the orange player breaking the balance of the game, so he could consider betraying me. But I would like to team with purple as long as possible, so by currently being stronger, I have to show some initiative for the purple player to stay with me as an ally by manual rolling the orange player's biggest army, so the purple player would know that I'm serious. But to be honest, I am not really sure what has happened here. The purple player said oops after putting his troops to Western Europe. I think he specially put his troops here but wanted that it would look like an accident. He probably wants the orange player to attack me through Africa, but I'm not totally sure. But I would assume he had some sneaky plan in mind, well, not necessarily against me. But maybe it was an accident for real. I mean, you can never really know how it is, if that person is not you. But anyways, the most important thing that the orange player didn't invade any of us, he will just simply let us crush our troops into him it seems, and that is so good. I've just kept manual rolling him, so the purple player would be encouraged to guard against him again, with the purple player not appearing to be so weak towards the orange player anymore. Just too bad the purple player didn't add his troops on the borders evenly, so the orange player could still possibly consider to break through. But alright, he just put the army back to Australia, so I can continue manual rolling him. I mean, I could just straightly blitz these troops, but to potentially weaker him more, I decided to manual roll instead and hope for the better outcome. Also, you probably saw that I had a 10 troop set at 3 cards, but I'm specially not trading it in until I'm forced to. I mean, it could potentially look for the purple player that we are equally strong opponents, but actually with having good cards advantage, I could potentially really outsmart him by betraying him first at the right moment if he doesn't realize that. And yeah guys, I think the purple player has just made me win by crushing his troops into orange right now. He didn't take into the account my card's advantage and the possibility to ruin his continental troop bonuses first, and also the cards I'm going to get from orange. It was obvious for the orange player that I've just won the game, so he decided to suicide on me. But I mean, I would have taken him out either way, so at this point it didn't really matter to me. Well, who knows, I might still end up losing. So let's actually see. But here we go guys. That's what I call a good blitz roll. The purple player lost 10 troops more than me. The attacker's advantage guys. And this is another reason to keep in mind in order not to give away the game for another player. The bigger armies are, the bigger advantage the attacking player is supposed to get. But yeah guys, I think I win this game. I have the advantage which I am not going to waste. I have more territories, I have more troops, and finally I'm supposed to trade in sets first as well. So it would be very unlikely for the purple player to make a comeback. But how do you like the deadliest trap strategy for the Australian player guys? It is being set up by the both America's player and African/European player letting each other hold the continents, only properly guarding against the Australian player, and then crushing the troops into him that it would be mutually beneficial for both of you. Of course, doing it smartly by keeping an eye on the troop counter, and taking into the account the other mentioned details, so at the end you wouldn't end up outsmarted by your ally. But that you would actually be the one who outsmarts others.